The Weeping Cove is rumored to be a resting place of Two-Toed Tobias, an ancient three-barrel legend. The Weeping Cove is rumored to be a resting place of Two-Toed Tobias, an ancient three-barrel legend. The cacophony of wailing and moaning becomes clearer as you enter the cave. An opening in the ground reveals another body of water to explore. The valve triggers a rush of water through the pipes, followed by the sound of a door opening. A strong current pushes against you. You hear doors close ahead and behind you. You fear that you are trapped. Cervantes, two-toed Tobias's first mate. A slight breeze emerges from behind the wall. A ship's mast rises up from a chasm in the cave floor. A frigid cold cuts through your body as you see a frozen river below. The source of the cold air is coming from this room. The fire jets melt the ice, allowing you to continue your search for two-toed Tobias. The second valve triggers another chain reaction, which opens the door to the rest of the dungeon. Let's go. Levers appear on opposite sides of the room, adorned with bullseyes. As the lever flips back, the floor rolls. The door before you opens as if you were expected. The supposed urban legend speaks to you.
It's about time someone found me. I have long waited.
The legend of Two-Toed Tobias was not just an urban myth, although it is doubtful that anyone will believe your tale of victory. The current is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through.
A thick fog rises up from the water as voices of pirates float along the current. Moonlight shines down from an opening above.
The entryway into the pirates' compound rumbles open. Strong breeze gusts from a crack in this wall. Suddenly, the clanking of wood and metal intensifies. You notice a lever on the back of the ornamental statue.
chilling air gusts out. It smells of raw, bloody meat. You hear the gnawing and crunching of bones inside.
Again, the clattering of war. Farian calls out to you.
Do not touch anything. One wrong move could kill me. Please, speak with me first.
A voice calls out from the back of the room. Please come in.
The captain bellows.
How dare you refuse my operation?
You defeated the captain and ended his illegal smuggling operation.
Have freed Farrier Warley from the ancient prison.
The current is drawn into an opening in the rock just large enough to wiggle through.
The gruff voices of hobgoblins can be heard nearby.
Thank you.
Several patrols are winding through the inlet's valleys. Take caution as you advance. Sail on Stormreach and blockade the harbor. Keep him from leaving the inlet. You have found 6 powder kegs. Use them to trap Yar-Yar's schooner while he's ashore. Yar-Yar's schooner has been discovered. This small vessel barely looks safe. The draft of Yar-Yar's flagship must be too deep to anchor in such shallow waters. Yar-Yar's schooner has been transformed into a floating bomb. You hear a bellowing voice not far away. Probably Yar-Yar realizing he's stuck ashore. Scartongue flails in agony. Stained Tusk howls in triumph.
Yar-Yar is dead. The Banshee is avenged. 3 cheers for our bonny rescuers.
Thank you. You awake from your unexpected slumber. At first, things seem as before. You're still at Wynwood Hall, and Melody is still standing beside the bed. Then you realize that Lord Arden is missing, and so are the flower and the lute you need for the ritual. Melody begins speaking in a familiar voice.
Lord Arden's true name? Of course I know it. But it's for me to know and for you to never get. Be a good adventurer and die to monsters in the wilderness while I go make sure Lord Arden never, ever wakes up.
She cackles as she teleports away. You see creatures milling around near the gate to Wynwood Hall. Then you notice that things seem different. This isn't the Feywild. You are trapped inside a room. You approach a shadowy form that appears to be Lord Arden, reading a note with a worried expression on his face. The figure doesn't notice your presence. You spot movement underneath the bridge. Moving closer, you see a nasty-looking troll guarding a missing loot. Bits of troll and drops of its blood splash into the river as the battle progresses. The bits grow rapidly into new bridge trolls that join the fight. You've recovered Hearsome's loot for the ritual. Inside the magically sealed gazebo ahead, Frosted Cerise. Now, where has Melody hidden Lord Arden? You notice a pillar of magical energy streaming from a distant portal. Perhaps that contains the secret. You approach the portal grove, but a pixie flutters into the path.
She said to make sure you didn't make it to her. I won't let you get near her. No, I won't let her.
The pixie smiles.
You won't get the rest of the ring to me. So long as they are fine, their devotion will stay.
As the pixie collapses. In his last moments, he says,
"You haven't won yet. You still need the next room.
You exit the portal and find yourself in a strange, empty hall. Yet that appears to be Lord Arden's resting place ahead. Between you and Lord Arden stands Cadence the Hag. She must have been disguised as Melody the Apothecary the entire time. Cadence prepares for battle.
Thrice damned adventurers never know when to quit. I should have seen that you can't trust a pixie to do a hag's work.
Cadence finishes her conjuration. Slimes emanating a frigid mist suddenly appear nearby.
You killed my sister, so I'll have to make do with these wild cauldron leftovers. I wouldn't go anywhere near them personally now. Be a dear and die for good this time.
Weakened and battered, Hades tries to surrender.
That's enough. You need what I have. So then, let's make a deal.
You've reluctantly decided to allow Cadence to live. In exchange, the Lord Arden's true. You lay out the ingredients for the ritual and repeat the steps to reverse the curse. First, play the lute. Then, grind up the flower's roots. Last, burn the roots along with Lord Arden's true name. You play a brief melody on Hearsome's lute. You mash the flower's roots into a pulp with little effort. You set a small blaze, then drop the crushed roots and Lord Arden's true name into it, completing the ritual. As the smoke rises, Lord Arden's eyes open. He springs out of the bed. Lord Arden thanks you for awakening him from this curse. He urges you to speak with him back at Wynwood Hall in the waking world. A motley group of redcaps guards the gate ahead. It's strange that a noble of the summer court would retain those violent, unpredictable creatures as servants. A curious tree stands here by itself. A single, brilliantly red apple hangs from one of its branches. The tree itself seems to sigh as you finish your song. Its branches quiver, and the apple drops at your feet. The sprawling courtyard seems deserted. A lone tower
looms
ahead.
What can I do for you, Outlander?
Lord Xavier will likely be found inside.
What can I do for you, Outlander? My part in this story is done. Time to rest.
This storehouse is occupied by a very energetic chest. It gapes at you with a big, toothy grin and
speaks. Five-letter word! Become shorter when you
I
add
am
two letters to
Come,
it.
Come, let us talk.
The tower is sealed. A true friend asks, a true friend may enter.
As you reach for the door, a swirling torrent of snowflakes envelops you. Yet, you aren't harmed. You don't even feel cold. Eladrin guards wearing the garb of the summer court await you in this room. One of them holds up a hand to hail you.
Strangers, I would parley before we come to blows. You may step forward and seek to speak.
You are faced with an unavoidable battle with the Eladrin. You have chosen to stay your blows and spare their lives, even at the risk of your own. Reached the top of the tower, where a regal Eladrin silently awaits your approach. He appears to be alone.
Yes, you fool! I'm still here! But your precious Graymoss is dead, trusting idiot. Who told you the Prince of Frost wanted you dead, Me? Who said these Outlander notes were his tools? Yeah, me. But it was you who were supposed to die willingly on their plates as a distraction while I do Hearthstone's bidding. But no, guess I just have to kill you all myself now.
The hag's form splits
into a shadow. You think again?
You have to watch closely to see which one is the real. The hag dies, screeching to the last. After a moment, the Viscount rises to his feet and blurts,
"Who was that? What's going on? I demand an explanation!"
The party here is in full swing, and Cascading Springs Cottage is clearly the worse for wear for it. A harried housemaid waits on the raucous satyrs. A satyr calls to you as you enter the courtyard.
Hello there. Welcome to our revels. There's food in the kitchen and drink, well, everywhere, including the floor, I see. Make yourself at home, and don't forget to pour one out for our dear host, to Lord Arden. May his slumbers be peaceful.
The lush collection of potted plants suggests that this room is the conservatory. A note next to the sack of seeds reads, "Slake weed. Keep away from sunlight and damp soil." Drop a few of the magic seeds on the ground. Huge weeds burst from the earth, and the thirsty plants quickly drain the moisture from the surrounding soil. Springhouse. It seems someone was trying to hide it. Surprising to find a large, well-stocked library in a house given over to an endless party. It's even more surprising to find a sphinx sitting in the middle of it. Water gushes up from the ground in one corner of the room, forming a large pool. This must be the cascading spring the house is named after. This large barrel is marked "Flash Powder" in large letters. In even larger letters below are the words, "Keep away from open flame." Towering weeds spring up the instant you cast the magic seeds on the ground. The twisting brambles suck up every drop of water nearby, leaving Cascading Springs dry as a bone. The careless satyr swings his torch too close to the powder keg, which explodes in a shower of sparks. The partygoers turn to gawk at the spectacle. You attempt to take the sign, but are spotted by the attentive satyrs before you can pry it loose.
What are you up to, then?
Surely you are letting your light fingers come off. Simple task to remove the sign. The satyrs are still distracted by the recent fire. You definitely replace the proper sign with the sign from the library. Seething with anger, the master of the revels reluctantly agrees to leave.
A deal's a deal, it's true. We'll leave. But nothing in the deal says we can't rip you to shreds on our way out.
The revels have finally ended, and not in the way the satyrs expected.